Okay, let's do some math for fun. And here's the question for you guys. As you can see on the screen right here, we have two circle-looking circles. And my question for you guys is that, which one is actually a circle? The red one or the blue one? What do you guys think? Well, maybe both. Well, maybe neither. And you guys can click on the button right there so you can vote, right? Alright, so that was round one because you might be thinking, hey, we didn't have enough information. So don't worry, here is round two. And let me help you guys out a little bit. And as you can see, I have the x and y axis for you guys. And they are still the same thing from earlier, okay? And let me tell you guys that the answer is that the blue one is not a circle. As you can see on the blue one right here, just pay attention to the middle. Well, it goes from negative 2 to positive 4, right? So that's 6. However, if you focus on the x-axis, it goes from negative 3 to positive 3, and that's also 6. And the problem is that that x-axis length right there is not the diameter for sure, because it's not in the middle. Therefore, it's not a circle, right? In fact, the red one is a circle. This right here is the polar equation, and I will convince you guys that this right here is indeed a circle. So now let's see. First thing first, r is r, 2 is 2, but for the sine theta, we can write it as y over r. And similarly, we'll just continue, plus 6, and for cosine, you have to remember, it's x over r. Now, this is very nice, because we can multiply everybody by r. And when we do that, r times r is of course r squared, and that's equal to just 2y here, and then just plus 6x. And now notice we have the r squared, which is the same as saying x squared plus y squared, isn't it? Yeah, and then of course we still have this, 2y plus 6x. From here, we can actually just move these two terms to the other side and complete the square, and you'll see this is in fact a circle in the Cartesian form, right? So here we go, this is x squared, I will pair up with minus 6x after I move this to the other side. Leave a space for the magic number, and then I will add y squared minus 2y, and then leave a space, and this is equal to 0 right here. Okay, notice that we have a 1 right here, so that's good. Go ahead and use the formula, right? This right here is negative 6. We have to take 1 half of negative 6, and then we square that, and that's negative 3 squared, we get positive 9. So I'm going to add 9 here, and add 9 here. This is the magic number. It's so magical, once you add it here, you complete the square, right? Okay, here we do the same thing. We are going to take half of this. So half of negative 2, and square that. This is going to give me negative 1 squared, so that's actually positive 1. Add a positive 1 on both sides. Again, magic number works out so magically because as you can see, this right here, it's actually x minus 3 squared. And this right here is y minus 1 squared. This right here is of course 10. As you can see, this right here is in fact an equation of a circle with the center at 3, 1. And the radius is, this is 10, but you look at the square root of 10 squared. So the radius is actually square root of 10, which is approximately 3 point something, right? Anyway, this right here is it. This is how you work with polar equations. Okay, before we go, I wanted to ask you, do you know someone who likes to ask, how do I get better at solving problems, or how do I get better at math? Well, if so, I have something for you. Check out brilliant.org. This is the holiday season, and you can help to spread the love of math to your loved ones by gifting them a Brilliant Premium subscription. This really excites me because it's such a fun way to nurture curiosity, build confidence, and also develop problem-solving skills that are crucial to their schools, job interviews, or maybe even their careers. And Brilliant's thought-provoking content breaks up the complexities into bite-sized understandable chunks so that you understand them much easily. You can go from curiosity to mastery. And now you can go to brilliant.org/blackpenrepen and grab a gift subscription to help your loved ones spark a lifelong love of learning. It's a circle, but it seems that I have another circle on my back. Anyway, hopefully you guys all like this video, and as always, that's it.